Welcome back. Now, in this Module 13 guided lab, we are going to implement a serverless architecture. So we will have like an S3 bucket where the upload of a files to this S3 bucket will trigger a Lambda function. And that Lambda function will be inspecting those files and reading them, and then store them in a DynamoDB table. So let us start now in step number 5, where we need to go to the services and we go to Lambda function. We need to create a function, and this function name is going to be load inventory. And this is going to be a Python 3.7. And we will choose an existing execution role. We will use a role which was created by the lab environment for us. It's called Lambda Load Inventory role. And now we click on create a function. Now the function code is provided to us in the lab sheet here, and I will make sure to put this function as well in the GitHub if you would like to retrieve it from there. So the function code is basically, we're going to select everything here and we paste it, and then from file we click on click save. We want to click save on the function. Now we want to basically deploy that function. We want to just deploy it, and this is basically will save the changes as well. Let us now configure an Amazon S3 event. Before we can do that, we need to go back to S3 and maybe we open it in a new tab. Now, once you open S3 in a new tab, we want to create an S3 bucket, and we will call this inventory. And let us give, for example, the date of today, 20th, 12/1. And now in this inventory bucket, we are going to create it. Now in this bucket here, we are going to upload a few files to it. So we are going to go to the property tab. And in the properties, we are going to configure an event notification. We will create an event notification, and that notification name will be a load inventory. The rule here is going to apply for all object create in this bucket, and the target is going to be a Lambda function. So the destination is going to be a Lambda function. You can select a Lambda function from the menu here, which is the one we just create, and then click on save changes. Now go back to your S3 bucket objects. In task 3, we are going to download these files here to our computer. So let me download them now and save the next one, which is the calcula, and then we save the third one. We save all of them basically in the download folder, and later we are going to upload them as well to S3 bucket, the one we just created. So now these files, we want to go to the console, upload, and we add files, and we select all of them from the upload menu and click upload. Now you can see now, once we upload them here, we are going to get a trigger, a notification, which will trigger the Lambda function. You could go to the Lambda function itself, and in the monitoring tab, you could track when that function was triggered as well, and when it was invoked. And let us go and show the details here. We have like a credential for the dashboard. We need to copy it. And we need to open it in a new tab. So this is the dashboard, which are basically viewing the content of the S3 from the bucket. Now let us go to DynamoDB. And in the DynamoDB, we have a table called inventory. And we will choose that inventory table. And we have like a few things to monitor here. We have the item summary, which is zero, the indices. You could also look to the structure of this table, and you can see there is the items in the current table. Now we want to configure an SNS notification. So let us go now to SNS, and we will create a topic. And this topic, it will be no stock. And this no stock is going to be a topic that we create as a standard. And we will create a topic. Let us create a subscription for that topic. And the protocol we want to use is going to be the email address. And we will enter an email here, like my email address. And then create a subscription. I should receive an email now to my college email, to this email address. I should receive an email, and that email will be basically used to subscribe. You can see I have a new email now, and I can confirm the subscription to this topic. Now let me go back, and this will basically, we will create another Lambda function to send the notification. So in this step here, we are going to go back to Lambda. And from Lambda dashboard, we can create another function. And we will check the stock in that function. And this is going to be a Python 3.7 as well. We will use an existing role, and that will be the Lambda stock, check stock role. And then we create a function. Now we will copy the code for the stock check, which is provided to us in step 43, and we copy it. The same way you can deploy or save, it's the same thing, and deploy. Now in the trigger, we are going to add a trigger, and we configure this as the trigger source is going to be DynamoDB. And the table is going to be the inventory table. And we click on add. So that anything that could happen on the DynamoDB table will trigger this Lambda function. So let's go now to S3 again. In S3, we will open the bucket that we just create, and we will upload a different inventory. I think I upload all of them. I should upload, for example, let me delete. I should upload a few files in the previous step. Let me go back now. And we will upload, for example, another file, which is going to be Busan. Now in the inventory dashboard, we are going to refresh the page, and basically we select table that we just uploaded here. And this is basically pretty much what you need to do for this lab. Thank you for seeing this.